Buenos días, soy Fabio. Vamos a continuar el estudio del español. We are going to continue the study of Spanish. Welcome back. Today, we are going to elaborate a little bit more on the differences between the verbs ser and estar, which happen to be, in English, the verb to be. These two verbs cause a lot of problems for students because of the different uses of it. So here we are going to practice and learn the differences between both verbs. Very important. These both verbs mean to be in English. They are used in very different cases, so we need to establish very carefully when to select each verb. Because these verbs are irregulars, they have different conjugations. That's why we are going to review very much what are the forms. So repeat after me. Soy, eres, es, somos, sois, son. Very good. Let's practice the verb estar. Estoy, estás, está, estamos, estáis, están. Please be very careful with the accent on this verb. Let's take a look at the verb ser in Spanish. Okay, what are the main uses? First, el origen. Second, identificación. Third, características. Cuatro, fecha y hora. Cinco, eventos. Posesión, material. Here's a list of very common adjectives. Take a look at some of them as they appear in the screen. Do you recognize some of them? You might. These are adjectives to describe people or objects or places. Yes, they all use the verb ser. Excellent. Origen. When we want to say the origin of a person or of a place, we need to include the preposition de. Juan es de España. El libro es de Guatemala. Mis primos son de Buenos Aires. Identificación. Let's identify people. Tú eres la hermana de Pedro. Nosotros somos americanos. El señor Ayala es profesor de español. And this identification had included the profession of the person. Características. Soy muy alto y delgado. Carmen y Pablo son jóvenes. Esta clase es fácil. So the verb ser help us describe physical or also personality. Hora y fecha. What's the question in Spanish for what time is it? Good job. ¿Qué hora es? Example. Son las 3 de la tarde. 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Hoy es el 17 de febrero. Today is February 17. Events. In Spanish events, when we want to say when they happen, we have to use the verb ser. Take a look. La clase es a las 8. Class is at 8. La fiesta es en mi casa. Party's in my house. Concerts are in the park. Los conciertos son en el parque. Preposition de allow us to use in Spanish or to talk about possession. El libro es de María. Rather than saying María's book, in Spanish we say the book of María. Material something is made of. Ejemplo. El pupitre es de metal y plástico. The desk is made out of metal and plastic. Let's take a look at the verb estar. The verb estar is used for the following. Uno, localización. Dos, condiciones. Tres, opiniones. Let's take a look. Some of the conditions in Spanish that we associate with the verb estar appear on the screen. Take a look at this. These characteristics or these conditions are not permanent. They are not descriptive. They are just telling how these objects or this person are feeling. or how things are like at the moment. Let's break it down the uses of estar. Localización. Location, location, location. En español, we use the verb estar. Madrid está en España. Mis libros están en mi casa. ¿Dónde están ustedes? Notice that all of these ones refer to either a person or a place. Not an event, but a person or a place. Conditions. Condiciones. So, take a look. El profesor está enfermo. This is a temporary condition that could actually change anytime. That's where we use the verb estar. Marcos y Elena están nerviosos. They are nervous. Mateo está contento siempre. Mateo is always happy. These are temporary conditions. Opinions. If you are about to try something or to taste something and you have an immediate reaction, you can use an opinion. Take a look. La sopa está deliciosa. You just tried the soup and you want to say, oh, it's delicious. You say, la sopa está deliciosa. If you were to say, la sopa es deliciosa, that means that it's always delicious. But in this case, I'm providing my opinion at the moment. El día está muy frío. The day is very cold. El señor Sánchez está contento ahora. Mr. Sánchez is happy now. Notice the use of ahora. Ahora implies immediately that is a temporary condition because things can change. So what are the uses of these verbs? Let's review one more time. The verb ser has the following uses. Say after me in Spanish. Origen. Identificación. Características. La hora. Un evento. Posesión. Material. The verb estar. Localización. Condiciones. Opiniones. Let's practice. Select among these two verbs. Which one do you think best works in this sentence? Mi amigo, you are right, es de la República Dominicana. Good job. Let's continue. Las 10 de la noche. I'm telling the time. What do you think is the verb that best works here? Good job. Son. Los libros de la profesora nueva. We are talking about possession. What do you think is the best form? Good job. Los libros son de la profesora. El partido de béisbol es a las 4 hoy. I just gave you a hint. Right. El partido es a las 4 hoy. ¿Quiénes los estudiantes nuevos? This is for identification purposes. Who are the new students? Good job. Son. Hoy yo nervioso. If you take a look, nervioso is a temporary condition. Good job. Estoy. Let's practice a little bit more. ¿Dónde el concierto de rock? Where is the rock concert? Es, because it's an event. Carmen and you are very tired. This is a temporary condition. That's right. Estamos. Los profesores. Teachers, busy. That's a temporary condition. That's right, están. El libro de historia, muy interesante. It's a very interesting history book. It's a description. Es, that's correct. Mi abuela, not very happy today, my grandma. Because I say today, that's a temporary condition. Correct, está. Good job, excelente. Let's do one more. Mi madre siempre ocupada. My mother always busy. Correct. Está ocupada. Muchas gracias.